Connecting it straight. 1, 2. Wireless microphone system. 1, 2. 1, 2. Hey. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. Sure. One, two. There is left and right here. There is left and right here. He could have came to me, but yeah, check it. They still can work. These two can still work.
I hope not.
Stormy Sunday blues. Glory, all my shame is removed.
just one touch of his garment. All my sickness is healed. Just one drop of your blood. All my life is restored. The blood that Jesus shed says I'm redeemed. I am set free. The blood that Jesus shed says I'm forgiven. I am accepted all through his blood. Just one glimpse of his glory. All my shame is removed. Just one word in your presence. All my fear is cast out. Just one touch of his garment. All my sickness is healed. Just one drop of your blood. All my life is restored.
Daddy, stop it.
The blood that Jesus shed, I'm redeemed. I
Billy, stop me. I'm 12. Today my heart is
broken. And I can't believe this is the last time I'll be speaking to you. We met 23 years ago, and yet it still feels like yesterday. I remember how I used to go the other way each time we crossed paths. Little did I know that I was straying away from my soulmate. You came into my life and you loved me. You treated me like a queen. You were there at the lowest point of my life when I lost my brother. You loved me unconditionally and you loved our kids with all your heart.
song we learned in Zimbabwe. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you.
Give you all, we give you all, we give you all, we give you all. glory. Africa will rise and give you glory. America will rise and give you glory.
1, 2, 1, 2. One, two, three. Can you all hear me? And the people outside? Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We wish to start our program for this morning. And we are going to do it in such a manner that we keep to the time as much as we possibly can. You know, we are living an abnormal normal. So that means we have to really subscribe to the conditions of COVID-19 and the guidelines as set, both by the World Health Organization and the government of South Africa. My name is Vetabile Polo. I hail from Lesotho, in the city of Maseru. The deceased is my direct younger brother. Now, in starting our program for this morning, I will now invite, I don't know whether I should open up in prayer or just invite, let's open up in prayer. I'll invite the pastor to open the service with a word of prayer.
Thank you very much, Program Director. Good morning, dear family, friends, colleagues. We greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's just pray together. Father, we thank you that we can be here today gathered in the name of Jesus, not in the name of a man, not in the name of a church, but in the name of Jesus, because your word says, ever gathers in the name of Jesus, that you are in their midst. And God of all comfort, today we need your presence in our midst. We welcome you, Lord. Please come and take your rightful place in our lives right now, is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Just a small appeal before I proceed. The many funerals that I've attended, I've had cell phones ring in the midst of the service. This service is no different from a church service. So I want to appeal to all those who have their cell phones to keep them on silent mode or to turn them off completely. Two, even if it's on silent mode, if I see you speaking with a cell phone in this church, I will come to you and humbly take your cell phone and ruthlessly break it on the cement outside. Thank you very much. At this point, I want to welcome you to this funeral. Great man by all standards. And since it's not for me to talk, I'll just give one condition for all those who are going to be giving a speech here, except for one person who will be giving us a cause of death. He can go up to 4 o'clock in the afternoon, I don't mind. But the rest, I'm going to try as much as possible to restrict you inside 3 minutes. Person. And while you're here talking and you notice that I come up next to you, you should know that your time is up, so that we don't take much more time than the pastor has allowed us in this church. I'll now call upon Dr. Tatulo Sepia to come and let us know the cause of death for this brother of ours, our father, our friend, Dr. Sven.
Thank you, buddy.
Hello. Thank you, Pastor, for allowing us into the church. Like the program director said, I am Dr. Patrice Piani. I'm also the deceased brother. We are very close, that's why I was with him through the day when he started feeling sick. Narita Peru called me on a Wednesday, forgotten what day it was. Just out of the blue said, you know, his men are out. I started to laugh before he said anything. He said, hey, can you believe it? I have this point. Why doesn't it go to a sheep or something? He don't laugh. What's going on? He said, no, I was out in a nursery when I started feeling sick, but I got better. So I asked him, but now how are you feeling? So he says, nah, a bit tired, what should I do? I said to him, as long as nothing changes drastically, like it's suddenly sweaty or suddenly short of breath, just self-isolate and all. But if anything changes, go to the hospital immediately. The following day he called me, hey, I'm in hospital. Oh, what happened? Oh, I'm struggling to breathe and stuff like that. Okay, now I'm on my way. So I drove from Joburg to Centurion. And when I got there, I was denied access to see him because of COVID protocols. So that was the first day. When I was able to pick up the doctor, the attending doctor, on the phone, and he said, I'll call him. I hung around, and the doctor did call me and said, things are not looking good. By looking good, I said, because we as doctors, we call it the way it is. I said, no, tell me. I need rather that you tell me. That's when the doctor said, almost 80% of his lungs are wiped out. And you know what that means. My heart sank, but for the sake of everybody, I held on to that information. For the sake of his wife, and then I didn't want to speak. I love them. But then I called him, he still answered his phone. And like laughing, he just said, I'll chat to you tomorrow. The following day, I called the very house. Then yesterday, it said, I'm struggling. So the doctor then called me again and said, hey, the amount of oxygen you have to give him is just too high. But I couldn't talk to him. But the following couple of days, he went in on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, he was still breathing on his own. And I think on a Tuesday he said, we have to ventilate him. That's when things started going passion. Then on the Wednesday before his passing, the hospital called the wife and me to come over. let it go. These things were not looking good. We were completely sedated. But I mean, couldn't talk to us. We had teeth and machines all over them. Then we left with the wife. And the following day we called us again. And a week tomorrow when we did the other day to see him. And later on, they called me and said, please come. So I also went. And things were not really looking good. Drove home around 3:30 in the morning of Saturday. They called me again and said, oh, it's done. I must apologize to you. Wife and his siblings, because I withheld a lot of information for your sake. I was hoping for a miracle. And he hung in there. He really hung in there against all odds. But he wasn't. COVID-related complications. And they also discovered something that he didn't know he had. He had some long-standing heart problems, which were never picked up. Rest in peace, little brother. I've lost a great friend. We used to travel together with him everywhere, outside the country, in the country. Yeah, I was really gutted. But thank you, Prophet. Swana Singh Kilimo Fusha. Kalibu.
Thank you very much, Ndate Tatulo. This is what actually took our brother, our father, our friend. Ndate Tatulo is a medical doctor. Tapelo was a doctor of books. I don't know the types of books he read, how different they are from the type of books, but they're both authors. But Tapelo could not prescribe penicillin. Ntate Tapelo could deal with knows what. Ntate Tatulo cannot do that. But they are both doctors. Thank you very much, Ntate. Ntate Pastor, I don't know whether it would be appropriate to have some musical interludes in between. I'm trying to look at the time so that you don't find yourself in trouble with the law. It's okay. Thank you, sir. We shall now call, I've got two people here that I trust who can chant songs at least after every two speeches or after every three speeches so that we keep up with time. And it shouldn't be long hymns. When she chants or he chants a hymn, we just sing one verse. He actually comes from a musical family, the deceased. So he wouldn't like to go where he's going without accompaniment of music. I will now call upon his sister immediately after to give us the eulogy. Mama, thank you so much, thank you. Makatla Malia, I wish you much Polo. And during the reading of the eulogy, I would love us all to stand up.
When I remember what the Lord has done,
see how far God's brought me, so I'll never go back anymore.
Thapelo Polo was born in Maseru on the 10th September 1972, the first son of the late Nabo Edwin and Mamo Tsidisi Elizabeth Polo near Letswela. He did his primary education at St. James Primary School in Maseru, from where he proceeded to Lesotho High School for his high school education and matriculated in 1989. He then went on the then European Economic Community, EEC College of Maths and Science in Maseru in 1990. Thereafter, he worked for Lesotho Telecommunications Corporation for 10 years, from 1991 to 2001, before commencing his tertiary education at the Vaal University of Technology in Vanderbijl in 2002. In 2004, Thapelo completed his national diploma and obtained a BTEC degree in electrical engineering at the same institution in 2006. Was awarded MTEC degree cum laude in September 2008. From Vaal University of Technology, Thapelo worked for Telecom SA, Pty Ltd, as a specialist in network provisioning management for 3 years before moving to Vodacom SA Pty Ltd, where he passed on working as a senior specialist for core network engineering. In September 2011, he commenced his doctoral studies at the Tshwane University of Technology, TUT, Pretoria campus. And he was also part-time lecturer for BTEC in radio engineering and electronic communication from 2012 to 2014. He has submitted 3 articles for publication in peer-reviewed journals, as well as 4 presentations at 3 national and 1 international conference. His research interests were in Internet of Things, 5G, artificial intelligence, and pattern recognition. Thapelo was joined in holy matrimony with Madibi Mulapo Mabuitumelo Polo, the only daughter of Mr. Mohaika Mulapo and Mrs. Flora Mapete Mulapo of Hlotse, Leribe. The marriage bore them 3 children, a son, Buitumelo, and girl twins, Tshepiso and Tshepang. He leaves his wife, children, 7 sisters, and 3 brothers. May his soul rest in peace. Robala ka khotso mohlakwana wa maphulo ya disema, maila ho ngwathelwa motho ya sajeng sengwathwana sa maopane. Motho yo e tla re ha e ja ho thehe meriti, ho be ho thehe e menyenyane ya diotlwana. Motho wa halakane wa bonthupi, motho wa di faheng masihla-sihla. Rasetla le poho mohatsa manyane, o tla le poho matsetsi a kae. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sidi. Thank you very much. I didn't think you were going to make it. Congratulations. I will now invite the uncle to come and give us his tribute. The uncle in Sesotho, ke malome. They're usually the first people to speak on issues like these. Otherwise, you'd be very much in trouble. That malome could possibly come to the Apollo family and claim his sister back. So, to avoid that, malome will come. Kimalume banda. Wanda. That day you can assist him with the song. As you can see, it's going to take about 30 minutes to get here.
Morena utsiba se usitloka Morena utsiba se usitloka Tapelo tsaruna di tla nyuluela Di tla nyoluela hodimo ho ntate A re bineng hosana hodimo Hosana hodimo hodimo Ntate, ke a leboha. Thank you, Mr. What you call allos. Uson tusitse ntate. Bana beso ha le bona ke eme mona. Ke ema ka ke le sebete sa gore ga baneneng ke tlo pata mohlabane. Ke ne ke sa rate haholo go bua ka Thapelo gona jwale. Ke tla bua ga ke se ke qetile. Ga e le gona wa le tjena ke kopa gore ga baneng le mamele hantle. All the way from Caldonville. Ile ga ba le problem tseleng not actually problem motšhana ka ene a ke tsamaya le yena ka koloi o ile a re malome ga re eme ganyanyana go na le ntho e ke e lebetseng ka re na e be ke eng mone a re go nna ke lebetse go nka leoto la gago ka golo wa bona ore ke one leg out itse ga ke go ena ke re monna nako ile ga re sa ya morago ge re lo batla loto wasi ba kita tabalasa, kita be kofi, so one is harzamai, kape kijafas. So haki fita mo nu program kialebala. Okay, all the same is right. Kita kupa hore haba nini andu melo ki kina lidi karolo ze taro ze tabuwa kazon. Ya pele kire ho umakutu waka. Uno unkile leto le mutuena ya bitwa mufu kajenu le samaya leo le ya mo le sa tsebenteng. Ha le le tseleng ntate a ba re ho wena e mona e ka re ke fihlile mo ke yang teng jwale nka khikina kgutlela morago o ye lapeng le bana le mpheleditse mo ke fihlileng ke right sa manka kgoso. So ha o bala ditaba tsena hantle wa utlwisisa ho rabaneneng leeto le ntate o na lenkile le family. Empa ha ga tsela koloi ha ya staka ha etsa next yena a ba ipolela fela ga baneneng jwale destination e ne ke leng ho yona ke moo ke fellang teng lona khumahadi le bana kgutlelang lapeng nka khi le kgutlela lapeng jwale o a bona hore ga baneneng ntate leeto la hae ne le feletse mo mo a file mme khi ho a kgutle le bana mme hono hono ho bontsha hore ha baneneng mme o bohlokwa ho ntate. Ha ke feta mono ke re ho yena batjhana le tla lokela hore ha baneneng di ipope ngatana hobane jwale sefate seo le ne le setlile ka sona se wele. Empa neng hobane le a tshepa ba bang ba lone le batho ba dikreke and so on le a dumela go ga baneneng o re seile ke seng ga tlhola ka mo bona. So then ha ke kena ho ya bobedi motshedisi ke tla kopa o ko eme hanyane ke bue le wena o ka eme motshedisi. Ntsirisi o tla lokela o ga baneneng o bofe kobotangwaneso e se le wena mme wa bana bana ba setseng makoti o tla lla ho wena o lokela o ga baneneng re le o ananele dilo tsa hae o se ka ba re motho wa hae o ile so then ha ke sa di kena. So ke re ho wena ngwaneso umpo o etse ore ga baneneng ho tloa ka jeno o sebe lelapa lane ke la ngwaneno empa nene ha a sa leno. So then ke kopa ore ga baneneng nako le nako o bona bana ba bompho eno hore na ba phela jwang ho etsala jwang pele mme molao wa ore ga baneneng ha a na le problem o lokela ga baneneng a o bolelele tsona a se ka re ga baneneng ae le wena o na le motse wa gago. So ngwaneso ke a nka thaba haholo a nka ka utlwa report-o gore ga baneneng le tshwarane hantle gape le batšhana botlhe around Msanje gore ga baneneng le bona ba tsebe go ga baneneng o mme ba lokela go ga baneng ba o mamele mara le wena o se ka sebedisa molao o thata o lokela o sebedise molao o kgona motho o mongwe le o mongwe o se ka wa sebedisa wa faro. Ya o qetela e ke buang ka yona gona ke le buile mme ya o qetela e ke buang ka yona ke ya ntate enwa ya na bitswa Thapelo. Ntate enwa o na bitswa Thapelo empa neneng ka morago gore ga baneneng apuka lelo fasile ka kwano. Ufumane bizo lele icha. Bizo lele icha. Kimo ufu. So ke utlwisisa go gabane re lokela re utlwisisa gore ka morago go dintho tsotlhe tse o ka di etsang lefatsheng ka morago go mono lefo le teng so ke re gabaneneng ga re celebrateng letsatsi lena la ntateno se nang lebitso a bitswang mofu ke a leboa.
I don't know what's happening here. But nevertheless, really, we are alone. I am at this hour. I am feeling one. I am not like that. What's all this about? Except one. I am not even sure if I am going to show you what I can do. But I am well. But I am well. When I last saw a little girl, I was a feeling. I still can't come to terms. Motating ona re tla mema bagotsi. Bagotsi ke lelapa leo mema boitumelo a tswang go lona la ga molapo. Ga se lelapa fela ebile ke marena. O tlo bona go thapela ona sa itheke mogalo. O sebete sa go fega ngwana morena. Mme lebitsong leno la lelapa la ntate Mohaika ke ngotse yana mona. Fela ntse ke thalasa matlho ke bone ka ke a mmona. Fela ke bone mme Flora ka bona Lebogang. Ha ke tsena ho na le ba bang ba ba ka tswang delegate ke yena mme Flora kapa ke Lebogang o tla bua le bitsong la bagotsi. Jwale abang ke yana ba le ile o ntse a matha ka ntle ka mang. Lebogang. Lebogang molapo, Lebogang mohae ka molapo. Oh, thank you ntate. Ke ne ke lo sa bagene.
I'm going to deviate. My name is Moki Molapo, by the way. I'm not Lebogang, so I'm fluent in English, but I'm going to deviate from, because there are 11 official languages in this country, so I'm going to express myself in my mother tongue language, which is the Sotho. Kopao Leboa, motsamaisi wa ditshebeletso tsena e leng ntate Rethabile Polo. Lebitso la ka ke Moki Molapo. Lebogang o teng mona, jalo ke moholo ho yena. Ka Sesotho ke Bokwena. Ke tla tshwanetse go ke bue lebitsong la gage. Ntate Mogae ka ga ba teng ka baka la mabaka a ke keng a qola. Empa mofumagadi wa gae o teng mona le ba. Jwale, I'm also conflicted for the purpose of this. Gobane thapelo ke mokgotsi wa ka. Jwale gape a ba tlotla a re nyala ka mona go rona. E le gore ke mokgonyana wa rona. Jwale, ka lebaka la nako ga ke no bua ntho tse ngata gagolo fela ka thapelo bana. Ke phetse le ena nako e telele ke a mo tseba mo ke phetseng teng gotlhe mo teng o ne a ntse a na le nna. And-e o onan chakera na kuingulun, wala makisabi di tenting, onan sa analin. Just going kila re hona na go eh that them go na take about long go bula lona ka tom bitsa dimo ke re no tap just call me mo ke re no ke batla go bula la santi le ha re eish a ke tsebe ke tla ka eh se ke rata na le mbadi ya re ko mo shaba ha mpe fela ke o ntso tsama le nna mo ka ntso potela ka mo ga go gaitse dinya ka mo monna yo re ke nye ntho e o yetsa nyete kere o tsebe nna mona ha iso mona go ne mona ha o ke ne ha o sa tswa ha e ba o ratana le gaitedi ena ka ena ha o sa tswa o ha mona hle go dumela o tla yo le go skotsi sa go na se fedile ba e tla ha o ya pele kwa no tla tike nna go tsi o ntota mare nna ka tloela o nyonyo bela ka mogao mo a ba o na ga tlo tsea ho lo fela mo teng se ba tsea ho lo fela so ke khale ke phela le thapelo ha ke tla tsa di formo ka bo ke tsa maya ke sebetsa di fofane ya re tsa ma gore ka ntho tsa tshwanyetso ho a botsiwa gona ke mang o tla mongola mona ebe na kwena ka ofela ke ntse ke ngwala hore for in case of emergency ho contact due tape ona la ke ngwana tsa ma ya a ya foga ya re ba mpotsa hey ke tsa ma ke le mo ke re o tlile le mo le fatse mona le mo hla go tla go tlotsa mo tla bona gona go tsa ma o ya ya la ha ke tsibina go etsiwa ya ke re o tla tsiba tsa tsinle so o tsa maile hantle le ha fitla ba mpolella o tsa ma monte so ne ke sa tsebe re tsa tsinle le mona na we ga tla be ke eme mona na re bua le yena ba ne ntse ke mo jetsa ke thapelo nna ya se ke batla go tlela ha a wa tumo ke batla go ke ke e se ke batla go gutla jwale ke tlo sia ka mona ga a ska tsa ma my last conversation le thapelo on phone net unjo tsa wa bona se kombina no tima mtaka se batla go kenyetsa sola e tla ga ke se ke le siyo o be lo re ha se kombina se ke di sabe go si etse tso ke ra ke mo go wena ke nda ke tla tsa ma pele mo teng le ande following ya ba phone la e ka ke tsoga ke se fu he mona le fulene la mo ga le no tlo mathe o ye kwa nanga keng o tlo tsiba ke sa tsebe re e tla be se le yona na go ene a tlotla a tsamaya so le bitsong la le la palam la po a ke se ke utlile ka mohla o le motho thapelo ha ona di jola beng ka po o tlile mmadi in fact ona tampele la re ke go motlwella tsamaya go ile sa le o neng kitsa tsamaya sa mogwe so thapelo re mmadi la nteng ona ya mosebetsing a shebane le lapa la hae o dila ka garageng ka mono so ne ke tlwaetse yone ke go sole ka tronkong ka montse o bala dibuka so yona nako nngwe a na qeta go graduate o na itse ke tle ke ye go yena ke be ke re okay ke tlatla mo teng but unfortunately ha na graduate for doctorate ne ke tsamaile ka mosebetsi so ha a keta gore ke batla go etsa MBA because o no ntse o etsa ke re o etse sa ba accounting ke rena. I cross bantu ngolo le ngo mo things going to take we to challenge intellectual capacity ha we yet. Are a ba sa chincha a register ama. So I would give him the books ke ga lo bala o le nda anka. Jwale ke be ke thapela ke bona na le doctorate na ke ne na ke na le masters. Ke kopa ko mpolela he ka se suthu rena. Ha o kopana le le khuwa jwale. O bana ha se kwana na le mietlo nya le tsiwa. A sotho bana le hore ntlo ya the ya theuwa moteng ke ke be ke mmotsa ke ka se go a otla re o bana wena ona le doctorate nna ke nna na se a ba tse a fela ha ke tsebe na ke tla ka ba ke is to pack the house so a ba tse a holo fela so every time I'm phone la I'm going to pack the house so o tsamaile a sa tla re mo bona but his memories will live forever ke utlo tshe modimo ha fosi ha peisi gang a tshimpa tshetlene na tshola go fositse ka ne ke sa lebella gore o tla tsama ka mogotsa so le bitsong la lelapa we had a good mogonyana ke a leboga mo ya hele ba di medi bohle o phomola ka gotse ke a leboga.
it was really wanted to move. Funny, I have a lot of happy, the life hard. It's a given night, little man. That day, Mook, you live so well, and I hold it. Tapron is up, but it's a ball. Yoloka, Muwewa, and that demo haika. That tapelo, when I be saw dribbling wizard. Bamos Bambarabolo and I knew some out, don't under tea and I was under demo haika, on a side. Ono bona fela ntsa fa pa nya maoto o sa bona ntse tsala fela bolana o ke kwa e bona ke lutse la ntate mo ha ya kala bolo la dribbling wizard la thapelo ne le folo banka ha ke tsena ona le nka bitso le ka e bitso le la folo banka le no ona ba pala team e bitso and the old ya ha so tya neng kwa. Jolo tsa kana go ndu o di le dinare ne di sa kopane ne di sa qallane le tswai. Folo bang. Madi be ontsa ha na madi be a folo ma. Ma bo itumela ontsa tla mpulala na go ntse ya bona. O kopane ka he le thapelo jwang. Ntlela ya banda te mo ikutla tla mpulala o ke ana tsa go ma thapelo. Yo sa ikwe ke tsa pampiri sekolo mona ngwa no sontsa mo ja direthe ile ana nantsa mo goma. Mothating ona ke le bona ntate motle mokwena ke tla bitsa jale metswalle re ne re fane ka sebaka sa batho ba babedi ke ile ka sebetsa selemoeng nako e telele haholo. Most of you in here were hardly ever ideas ka nako eo a ntse ke sebetsa selemoeng, so I know what I'm talking about. I bua ka nako because ha le moyo ngo tlamela se betsa kana ko alawa se batla se kwala ba mameletse ding tse se bangolo kana ko ke bisa metswalle jwale emedi motswalle a le mong e ka bang o teng a thewa le sotho ba ntapelo ke citizen ya na hatsepedi ke citizen ya le sotho ke citizen ya Afrika Borwa. Ka lehlohonolo Basotho ha ba motseke jolo ka motswala ya ile a tsekwa ke motswala wa ntate Tshepo Tshola enwa ka kotloloko. For those of you who don't know, but ka lehlohonolo yana ha tsekwe ke ditšhaba ona sa tsekwe ke batho ona tsekwa ke ditšhaba. Jwale ke tla bitsa motswalle a le mong ya hlahang Lesotho ya ba le teng. Ne ke ile ka eletsa gore ka mohlomong o ka nna etsala gore ba ka kena ka magangrang, so I don't know how far those arrangements went. Fela ke bone gona koloi tse mmalwa tsa dinomoro tsa Lesotho mona ke tsone a ke metswalle ya thapelo kapa ke bo a ba le teng motswalle wa hae sebaka sena ke sa e tla ba motswalle a le mongwe wa Lesotho le motswalle a le mongwe wa Aforika Borwa ke lefa sebaka sena baesong. Lato ka re mi sa ka ntho yo tumeng ka yo e bana re se la tle pula mo fumari re sentse re bua buya ka lapeng ba sa yo tumeng ka re tshwarela.
Good morning. My name is Sello Seleki, ke motswalle wa South Africa. Re le batswalle ba thapelo re lahletswe haholo. Na I regard him as my brother. because ke kopane le Thapelo when he was doing his BTech at Val University of Technology. What happened there, I was in a bad state, and somehow since that day, I think, even before I had hospital, he gave me a call. So we were talking like every second day. So it is difficult for me to stand here and talk about this guy. So I'd like to tell a short story. This guy took me to Lesotho a couple of times. My passport, I think 80% of my trips was Lesotho. So I know his family and they know me, and and now I'm part of that family. So in Lesotho, he took me to Katsidem, whereby Unali big dam where Yameti. I would like to relate my story in a way that fits Thapelo's life. So what happened is he took me to Katsidem, then they showed me the process, Metsi a Dihlaba project, whereby South Africa needed water, and Lesotho has abundant enough resource at this commodity, Yameti. So what? So, in a nutshell, what happened is Katsidem is feeding South Africa with water via a Mwela hydropower station. So we went into those plants, he arranged we can go and see what's up, because he was an engineer. You know, engineers are very inquisitive people. They would like to analyze, they like to see things. So we went into that hydropower station in Mwela. He showed me, they drilled what you call holes from Katsidem feeding into Mwela, which is generating electricity for Lesotho. And Metsi are generating electricity for Lesotho. They will go down to South Africa into our Veldam. So what I'm trying to say with my short story is that we as South Africans needed something from Thapelo. He was a loving gentleman, and I don't know, everybody who met Thapelo, it's his friend. So he was so accommodative and gentle in a way that he fits very well with everybody. So Lesotho had this jewel called Thapelo, and Rona in South Africa here, we needed something from this guy. So he came down to South Africa. And why I'm relating the story? Because Val Dam, that's where Thapelo, when he left Lesotho, he came to Val, right? That's where we met. In he was doing his BTech. I was also doing my BTech there. So so somehow I could see this guy, we ended up being family. He would go to my family's house to check on my granny while I'm not there. When he's passing to Bloemfontein, he'll say, "Hey, my man, I went through here and checked on your mother." So yesterday, there were two sessions of memorial services. So what happened there, everyone who knew Thapelo was his friend. I hope you understand. And now, since I'm talking about that, I'm going back to my story. So Val Dam, it was serviced at Val and went to a rainwater board, where they purify this water, and then Taps. Taps is Thapelo's nickname, right? So we went into our cups, and he filled up our cups, Thapelo, with a gentle and very loving soul. So so somehow he was meant to come, and the way he took me to that Katsidem and all that, it was just to show me, but somehow it's relating to my story. And after he came to Vaal, educated at Vaal, and then distributed this water, which is a commodity from Lesotho, Tapelo himself, to Pretoria, whereby he opened taps as well. Because yesterday and the whole of yesterday, people were talking about Tapelo, right? The way we know Tapelo, Kimoto loving, he loves his family, he loves his friend, he's a friend with everybody else. So after that, he went to Vodacom, whereby they opened another taps there, a loving brother, everybody's happy. I was so touched about yesterday's memorial service by the guy called Ronald. So I'm. Let me be short. The man I knew, Tapelo, he loved his family. He loved so, his family so much. And there's one lesson he taught me. As friends, we need to share the favor. Maybe everybody here might take a tip from Tapelo's cup. We need to share all the favors, all the favors that our friends does to us. Because Tapelo, for me to get married, Tapelo played a very important role. He went to take out a letter to Buhari Mbaka, and he actually, on my wedding day, he ran the program. So I'm so deeply hurt into it, I think, with Tapelo. So I'm emotionally not okay, because I've lost a friend, a brother. So, okay. All right. Let me close up by saying to family, Osmadi, you know where we are. If we talk at two, so give us a call. Me and my wife will be there for you. Abutilebu and family Osmatiriso, I've learned to know you guys, and I'm grateful that you raised this beautiful soul. Thank you so much.
Sebaka se ke se fumane today go bua ka Star Black. Nna ke metsa Star Black, ka dula ke metsa Star Black gobane ke lona lebitso lene ke mo tseba ka lona. Re lahlehetswe ga re lahlehetswe. Tapelo was a good man, bile ka motho e mo mogang tsa tsho.
Lewena mogolo wa ka Star Black re le bua ntate tabe eno e buileng e matla haholo mme re ananele ke tla bitsa. We have to cut our program short, fortunately nako e re siile, so haeba re hloka ntate moruti mona for him to still be licensed as a pastor of this church, he must subscribe to the conditions are set by the powers that be. So I wouldn't want to be part of what denied him his license as a pastor here. So we have to cut our program short, unfortunately, because of time. We ought to be out of this church at 12. So I want to guess that it's almost 12. Nadim Ruti still has to give us a sermon. So we are going to cut it short. There was a memorial service at Tapelo's workplace yesterday. So I want to believe that his co-workers from Telkom and Vodacom were given time to give their speeches there. So I must apologize to them if they are present here, that I'm going to deny them of this opportunity now. I can't do anything, my hands are tied.
but I'm just taking advantage that yesterday you had a memorial service and possibly you may have said a few things at the memorial service. Very sorry for that. So I'll go straight to a tribute by the children. This one is one that I cannot cut. A tribute by Tapelo's children. I don't know. Kapa Ujaki Kanane. Yes, can.
I really have a lot to say. With the given time that we're given, I have a lot to say about Malume. But I'm still numb. We're still numb. Words cannot describe the difficult moment that we're in. But if this is the last time I get to say goodbye to Malume, then I'll do so with the knowledge that I've lived this life, and he has lived this life as my uncle, and me calling him Malume, and my three siblings having called him daddy. I remember the time I started being in the entertainment industry and becoming a DJ, and I was scared to tell Malume Tapelo because of how skeptical he would get, because he would always question what, when, how, why do you want to do what you want to do? And I had to tell Malume Madibi because I knew I could, she would say, yeah, go for it. But one thing that I am happy about is the fact that Malume got to see me evolve and grow to be this person that I am today. Dr. Pulo, you were and always will be an inspiration to myself, the entire family, and everyone you worked with. You have left a void in the family that cannot be filled. I loved you because you stepped in as a father figure, and you did more than a father would do for their child. I loved you because you were more than just an uncle. You were my best friend, and also a best friend to Tepiso, Tepang, and Dumi. Someone we confided in without any hesitation. I loved you because of the way you showed your love on other people, your siblings, your nephews and nieces, and most importantly, how you loved your family and how devoted you were to Malume Madibi. While we mourn and celebrate your life today, we also take comfort in the fact that your mission on earth has been fulfilled. And we thank the Lord for your life, and we bid you farewell until we meet again. I love you, Malume. We love you eternally. Thank you.
The teacher in me was tempted to spank you because the girl did dialogue, so you got time, yes, as I don't like it, so we live in Labanabata. When I will be well, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, really, boy, hey, Oscar, can he? Pelere. Bana ba botlhapelo ba teng mo ya mo hlahlamang o teng mo ke kopa ka motsotso fela a tile boang a ka tle a itlo tela eno a butiae.
Uncle, sebedisa ka ofela ba teng kwano ke le boha mpholo jwalo ka ha ho se o letswe ke mogolwane wa rona eno a robetseng kwano wa ko bae ba o qetela mme mabotumelo ke kopa ka sheko re ke keteke bophelo bo a dithapelo a bophetseng. He lived a great life and we need to celebrate his life today. Re lahletswe ke moholwane wa rona, re lahletswe ke kgaitsedi ya ke go lahlehetswe ke mohatsa wa gago. Ke kopa ke se ke ka tswela pele ke tla tloa ke loba dipalo ke a leboga.
Ba qetela re tswa ho tsa ditaba ho ntate Moruti. Ke nako ya mme Madibe ena ya ho lana e tlo dumedisa moratuwa ena wa hae. Jwale ke hopola ya ka ho itse ona le puo e ngotsweng ha ke tsebana e hore ha kae kapa o tla tseba ho tla ya maipuella a na ya haufinyana kae puolelo ya mme Madibe. Anybody knows anything about it?
Yes.
Oh, good. Re tla mamela polelo ya mme Madibe a dumedisa ntate Thapelo. E tla bapalwa mane motšhining.
Ntate, thank you.
Years ago, and yet it still feels like yesterday. Remember, Daddy, stop me, Motuaka. Today my heart is bleeding, and I can't believe this is the last time I'll be speaking to you. We met 23 years ago, and yet it still feels like yesterday. I remember how I used to go the other way each time we crossed paths. Little did I know that I was shying away from my soulmate. You came into my life and you loved me. You treated me like a queen. You were there at the lowest point of my life when I lost my brother. You loved me unconditionally and loved our kids with all your heart. Your warm heart, kindness, and smile touched so many lives. You made me laugh when I didn't want to. My heart is broken. I prayed so hard and you fought like a soldier. But God had chosen me. I am thankful to God to have met such a beautiful soul. And I thank you for keeping your promise of loving me till death do us part. I will choose you over and over again. Rest easy, my love. We love you till we meet again.
Is the love of God.
boitumelo me nako ena ke nako ya gore lelapa le tse itebogo mme ke bona go bile go ntse ngwe tse di bitswala ka monono gore ke ye tse itebogo empa ke tlameya go gana ditaelo mothating ona ke meme ntate dintlhapholo ga se na go nyamele se kae ke meme ntate dintlhapholo gore ka motsotso le mo fela a ka itlogele boela tshebeletsong ena re tsebe go fetisisa go ntate moruti
botlhe ba teng kwano ka lebitso ke dintlhapholo ke mogolwane eno a ka pela ka kamo it's a tough day. We all call him brother. Ke ga ngwana ka, I stand corrected. Thapelo tsa rona di tla nyolohela. Di tla nyolohela godimo ho ntate. I said he was a prayer personified. I said he was happiness personified. Taba tse pedi tseno no di describe thapelo ka kotlolo. O no thabile ha ona le yena. O no ntse o rapela ha ona le yena. Because whenever you were with him, he was always trying to build you. He was always trying to lift you. Doesn't matter what you were going through. He was always trying to uplift anyone that's in his company. Ke lebohela bophelo ba hae, ke lebohela boteng ba hae, hore ebe o la ba teng mohlakwana eno a ka pelaka. Ha ke na tse ngata tsatsing lena ho boima batswadi, empa re lebohile re le bahlakwana. Bitsong la lelapa, re thabetse boteng ba lona, re thabetse support ya lona. And please, do more for others. Our brother gave lessons. I hope you are all listening. As for the announcement, ke a leboha ka taba tsa dithapelo ka nnete. Ke tshepa hlakotisitse. For the announcements, ntate ke kopa o tlo nthusa ka tsona hobane ke batla ke di lebetse ka nnete, kelello ya ka e sebetse hantle tsatsing le. Please.
That for the time you have allowed me to stand here and talk a lot of nothing. I will take this service and hand it over to the pastor in charge. Thank you, sir.
Speakers, for the lovely memories that you've shared, for sharing with us the impact that Thapelo had in your lives. And on behalf of our pastors, Pastor Burdenshan and 3C Ministries, we want to just express once again our deepest condolences with you as a family, Maliba and children. And please know that in this time that you are in our prayers and that we are here for you as a family. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you Your word says that even in death, that we are more than conquerors. Because those who are in Christ can never die. We thank you for the gospel of Jesus Christ. That Jesus died, he was buried, but he was resurrected. And therefore today we are a people of hope. Because we know that death is not final for a child of God. But we are trusting and we believe that in the same way that Jesus was resurrected from the dead, that even our mortal bodies will be resurrected, will be changed in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for your comfort and your strength on the family. Every friend, every colleague here today, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. Thank you very much for this honor that I have to be with you as a family, Malibe. Tapelo was one of our cell leaders, our cell members, a while ago. And what a great testimony. Thank you for sharing that with us when you said, thank you for staying true to your vow until death do us part. What a man. It says so much about Tapelo. Thank you very much for sharing that. Beloved, I want to remind you today on the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, where he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The words when he said that I am the resurrection and the life. And that's why today is a day of mourning. Today is a sad day, where we lay to rest husband, father, brother, friend, colleague. But in the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 4, Jesus made a profound statement when he said this, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. You know, so often, especially in this time that we're living in, we just want to move on with life, business as usual. But Jesus sets the standard here, and he says, looking at the word blessed, you are truly empowered, you are strengthened when you can mourn. Mourning is not what anybody can experience. Many people are sad, but the ability to mourn is a God ability. You see, many people want to deny the pain that they have, and they want to suppress it, and that's why people never receive restoration after the departure of a loved one. But Jesus said that it is actually a matter of being blessed of God when you can mourn. Because when you mourn, God can comfort you. And I want to encourage each and every one of us here today that we don't do what people say. No, you need to be strong. No. The word says that it is in your weakness that the strength of God is revealed. Mourn. Take ownership of the loss. Because then only will you be able to celebrate the life of Tapelo, truly. All the great testimonies that we've heard, the impact that he had on people's lives. We thank God for his life. In 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 3, the word says, all praise to God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is our merciful Father and the source of all comfort. God is our source of all comfort. And that's why the word says that we need to run to him. That we can come confidently to the throne of grace to receive his mercy. You must know that because of the blood of Jesus that you have access today to run to God. To to mourn in the presence of God so that God can restore and comfort and strengthen you. Beloved, I just want to share a short word of encouragement with you today. Knowing that there was a definite time in the life of Tapelo where he received the Lord Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. And it's for that reason that even in our mourning today, that we're not a people without hope. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 11, God speaks to the prophet and he says to him, cry out, shout this message. Now, if you look at the heading there, the heading says, comfort my people. Comfort them by shouting out these words. And he says, but Lord, which words? What must I shout? What must I declare? Which words can really comfort people? And the first time when I read these words, I did not understand what the Holy Spirit was trying to say to people who are in brokenness and mourning. And then it says here in Isaiah 40 verse 6, he says, let me just quickly get there. He says, tell my people, what message shall I proclaim? I ask. And then God said, proclaim this message that all human beings are like grass. All human beings are like grass. They last no longer than a wild flower. Grass withers, flowers fade when the Lord sends the wind blowing over them. People are no more enduring than grass. Yes, grass withers, flowers fade, but my word remain forever. You know, in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, the word says, it is better to attend a funeral than to attend a party. He says, for some people are foolish. They never ever think about the reality of death. And they live their lives as if they would never die. In the book of Psalms, chapter 90, verse 12, Moses cried out to God and he said, Lord, teach me this one thing, that my days are numbered. Because when I understand that my days are numbered, I will come with wisdom to the table and not live a life of foolishness. You see, dear friends, brothers and sisters and family, we all have an appointment with death. Each and every one of us here are appointed to die once. And the word says, then comes judgment. Not condemnation, he speaks about judgment. It's two different things. We will give an account to God for what we have done. Because the life that we now live, as the one brother said here in front, let us sow our lives. Because the life that we now live is a seed for your eternity. You see, in Christ there's no condemnation. But you can be in Christ and never receive the reward because you never sowed your life. And it's a pleasure to hear how he sowed his life, how he invested into people, how he loved his wife and his family. But this is what the word says. Comfort my people and tell them that they are like grass, that they are like flowers. Grass withers, flowers fade, but my word remains forever. If you look at this beautiful flowers here, may I have one? Let me just show you the beauty of flowers, the beauty of life. But God says, I want to give you some comfort today. People are like grass. They are like flowers. Flowers fade. Grass is, but in the end, what will remain is my word. Remains forever. When I heard that scripture the first time, I did not understand what God was saying to us as believers. And then the Holy Spirit took me back to Genesis, the creation of flowers and grass. And I remembered how God spoke to the earth. And he said to the earth, "Earth, bring forth plants and seeds and trees." And when the infallible word of God penetrated the womb of the earth started giving birth to plants, trees, seed, like these flowers. When God made the fish of the sea, he spoke to the waters. He said to the waters, "Water, bring forth fish and sea mammals." And the same thing happened when the eternal word of God, the seed, penetrated the womb of the waters started giving birth to animals, sea mammals. And the same thing when God created the heavens. God spoke to the heavens and said, "Heavens, bring forth stars and moons and planets." And the same thing which had actually discovered in reality, where they found the womb of heavens where stars were born, and it's still the word of God that he spoke in the beginning is still today producing grass and seed and plants. The word that God spoke in the beginning still producing fish and stars. You know what? What is the good news in this? That when this plant dies and withers, it goes back to its origin again. It goes back to the earth again. It becomes dust again. When a fish dies, it becomes water again. When stars burn out, it becomes the heavens again. It returns to its source out of which it was born when the seed of God connected with the womb. What is the good news? The good news is this, that when God created man, he did not speak to the earth. He did not speak to the heavens. He did not speak to the waters. But he spoke to himself. And he said, "Let us make man in our image." And in the image of God, he created them male and female. He created them. You see, this is the same with a flower. When a flower is uprooted and disconnected from its source, it will die. This flower still looks beautiful, but because of its disconnection, it will die. It's the same with humanity. When humanity becomes disconnected to his source, it dies. Not speaking about the first death, but the second death. But those who die in Christ will live forever. I love what the word says. When you look at Jesus, when Jesus on the cross, when he died, the word says he gave up his spirit and he said, "Father, into your hands I give my spirit." And he gave up the spirit. We know that his soul went to Hades. And we know that his body was buried in a tomb. Spirit, soul, and body. But then on the third day, he rose from the grave. And a resurrection happened that gave him a brand new body. A brand new reality. And this is what we see, which is the hope in the flower. That's why Jesus came. When the Pharisee, when Nicodemus came to Jesus and said, "Lord, how do I enter into the kingdom?" Jesus said to him, "Nicodemus, unless you are reconnected to your source, you will not see the kingdom of heaven. Unless you are born again, it will not be a reality in your life." And that's why the word says that flowers will fade, grass will wither, but in the end of the day, what will remain is my word in your life. And that's why we are comforted today, because we know this. that when it comes to the life of Thapelo, that he received eternal life. He did not receive eternal life the day that he passed on, but he already received eternal life the day that he received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And when he departed from this life, he just stepped over into the eternal. He's currently living what we are still dreaming about. You know, eternity is not about time. Many people think eternity is just to do with time. It's not like that. Eternity speaks of no beginning. And if there's no beginning, there's also no end. There's no decay. There's no more COVID. There's no more sickness. There's no more shortness of breath. But there's a completeness. There is a wholeness in eternity. And therefore today, we have this comfort because we know that, as Paul said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, 6 to 8, he says, the time of my departure is at hand. You know, he told his disciples, I'm about to die. I'm about to depart from this life. In the same way that Jesus told his disciples, listen, we're going to go to Jerusalem. They're going to crucify me. They're going to kill me. And the disciples took offense and they said, no, it's not going to happen. Forget it. You know, we don't want to hear that a loved one may depart. But you know what? Depart is a word with a very rich meaning. The word depart is actually in that context a Roman word. You see, for you to depart to another destination, you need to leave a current destination. For you to be able to enter a new harbor, you need to first leave the harbor where you are now. And I don't know who of you, I believe that some of you have seen the ships on the horizon, on the ocean. You see the ship on the horizon and suddenly it disappears. It's gone. You see, but the fact that that ship is out of sight does not mean the ship's journey has come to an end. It's just out of our sight. And that's why you must know today that when you are in Christ Jesus, that there is no end to your journey. Your journey will just step into eternity because of Christ Jesus. And as one of the speakers said, farewell until we meet again. There will be a meeting again. And I know that if Thapelo could say a few words today, then he would shout it out with all his heart. Believe the Lord Jesus Christ. Believe the word. And therefore, with that in mind, I want to encourage you that if you have not yet received the Lord Jesus Christ, that you put your faith in Christ so that you can receive eternal life even before you pass on to the eternal. And therefore, today, know this, that we are praying with you. We trust in God for God's strength and God's comfort over your lives. We thank God for his life. We thank God for his submission to Christ, that he received Jesus, that he accepted the truth. And we pray that that spirit will continue in your family, that you would be the salt, the people of impact that he ever dreamed for you to be. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Father, we thank you for your word today. We thank you, Lord, that we're not a people without hope because of Jesus Christ. And thank you, Lord, that you give us today an opportunity that we can be reconciled to you, that we can repent today and turn to you as our Lord and Savior. While every head is bowed and every eye closed, maybe you sit here today and you realize, Marius, you know what? I'm not where I'm supposed to be. Jesus said to those who them he gave the right to be called children of God. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Who's sitting here, I want to receive Jesus. I'm shocked by the reality of life that I'm appointed to die. I want to give you an opportunity. And just at the count of three, I'm not going to stretch it out. At the count of three, if you're standing here today, sitting, our viewers on Facebook and YouTube, where you are, if you find in your heart that you're not right with God, at the count of three, and you say, Marius, I want to make right with God. At the count of three, I just want you to quickly slip up your hand, put it down, and I'm going to include you in this prayer. One, two, three. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I see all those hands. Thank you very much. Maybe you stand here today, you say, Marius, I have received Jesus before, but I'm not where I'm supposed to be. My heart has grown cold. But today, I want to recommit my life to Jesus. If you're that person, quickly slip up your hand as well. One, two, three. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I see all those hands. I'm going to pray a simple prayer today. And all I want you to do is I want you to pray this prayer with me. We're all going to pray it loud. Say with me, Heavenly Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. Today I receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take out this old heart. Give me a new heart. Wash me and cleanse me. And I thank you, Lord, according to your word, as I receive you, I am a child of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, just where you are, beloved. Don't you want to stretch out your hands to the family this side? Father, we thank you that we can pray for the family today. We cover them in the blood of Jesus, the blood that flowed from the side of Christ on the cross. The blood of restoration that brings healing and restoration of our hearts. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you continue to comfort and strengthen them. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Pastor, and we don't have any notice for now, except that from here we shall proceed to the cemetery. I don't know whether to say for a private burial or what, because I'm not quite sure about the conditions as far as that is concerned. Proceed to the cemetery, and whatever notices will be made for thereafter, we will make the cemetery. So I hand over to the style funeral services to do the things that they are most famous of. Thank you. I beg your pardon. While the pastor leads the deceased out, a small notice is that from the grave site, we will proceed to Thatchfield Golf Course. where the meals will be served. Going but we'll proceed to Thatchfield, of course.
They could show beautiful songs that you sang. The world's on its feet. Congratulations, precedence is standing ovation. Kings and queens salute you. The whole of the camp congratulates you. Thank you.